Well, g'day, g'day, it's Tim Buchalka, the Aussie Android Dev Guy, here with yet another video. This time, we're setting up and installing libGDX, which is a game framework using Android Studio for Linux. Now, if you're running a Mac or a Windows machine, click on the links over to my left, and you'll be taken to a video where I show you how to do that on your platform. But again, this video is all about configuring and setting up libGDX, a game framework using Android Studio for Linux. Let's get into it.
Okay, so let's do a search for libgdx, then go to the first result, which is libgdx.badlogicgames.com, and click on that. And once we're there, we're going to go to the download, click on download, then select download setup app. And I'm going to save that. It's quite a small file. You can see it's now downloaded. So we're now going to open that file. I'm going to double click it. Now, if that doesn't work, depending on the way that your Linux machine is configured, that may or may not work. If double-clicking it doesn't open this for you automatically, then what you can do, and remembering we're in the Downloads folder, I can go back to open a terminal, go into the Downloads folder, and I can type java-jar-gdx-setup.jar. And that will open it up that way. So either way, one of those should actually work for you. So I'm just going to go back and close the terminal down now and go back and double click it. Okay, so now we've got a few things to do here. So we need to know the name, the package, the game class, destination, and the Android SDK. Now this is the libgdx project generator. So the idea of this is it generates the project, the shell, if you will, of the code that you need to be able to use libgdx. So you use this tool once to create the project, and from then on you edit it and create your game using Android Studio. So this is the shell. So what we need to know, we need a few things. We need to know the destination, where we're going to save the project, but also the Android SDK. So the best way to find the Android SDK is to go back into Android Studio and just grab that link that we had. So I'm going to open Android Studio. Because you recall, if you followed along at home in the previous video where I set up Android Studio, we went in and set up and located the directory where the Android SDK is deployed. The other thing we'll remember while we're here is the home folder. So we're storing our projects in Android Studio projects. So we need to remember that because we're going to be putting our project in there. So I'm going to close down the project, current project, and go back to here. And you're going to configure project defaults, project structure. Now here's our Android SDK location, so I'm going to take a copy of that. I'm going to paste that into the other app. I'm going to cancel the screen for now. Go back to our generator. I'm going to, in here under Android SDK, I'm going to paste that path in. Now destination, you remember, was the home folder, and Android project. So I click on browse for that one. It was Android Studio project. So I'm just going to select that. I'm going to click on OK. But we're also going to add something to here. We're going to add the name of the folder we're going to use for this project. I'm just going to call it /test. So that's where it's going to write the files. So the name, I'm just going to be pretty simple. My first game. Package. I haven't really got time in this video to talk about packages. It just needs to be something unique. We'll address packages in another video. And game class is the initial game class that is executed when the project starts. When the game starts, so we'll talk about that later. So for now, also keep in mind that sub-projects are there because libgdx is cross-platform. It works on all those platforms. I'm going to just take the ticks off all those inferior platforms, I'm kidding, and just leave Android on. So now in terms of extensions, if you don't know what these are, you can just hover your mouse over there and you'll get some help. So Bullet, just to give you a bit of an overview, is a physics library. FreeType is a lightweight fonts tool, so it does sort of saves the space typically associated with bitmap fonts. Tools gives you things like texture packers and the ability to generate fonts. Controllers is for joystick and gamepads. Box2D is a 2D physics library, and Box2D Lights is lights and shadows for that 2D physics library. Ashley is an entity framework, and last but by no means least, AI is the artificial intelligence framework that is now part of libgdx as an extension. You can also click on show third-party extensions and grab one of those or one or more of those things depending on what comes up as well, and you can see that these aren't maintained by the libgdx team. We won't do that now. So I'm actually going to deselect everything, but you would normally have box 2D selected, but I'm going to leave that all like that. So once we've done that, we can go into advanced if we want to, but we won't need to, but just to show you what it looks like. That's if you're using Eclipse or some other setup, but we're not doing that. We're using Android Studio. So to do that now, all we need to do is click on Generate. Now this will possibly pop up on your system if you've got a more recent version of Android Build Tools. And because literally in the previous video I downloaded the latest versions, we're sort of ahead of the release of libGDX. Usually you're okay, but if you can try this, and if you did run into difficulty, you could go back and fix that if you need to. And by downloading a previous version. Likewise with the API, we're using API level 21, which is Android Lollipop. They haven't tested it fully with libGDX, but with that said, it's going to be okay. But if you did have a problem, you could always go back and regenerate it and just sort of download a previous version first. So I'm going to click on yes, though, to use both. So you can see on the screen below, it's now downloading the relevant files and bits and pieces that it needs to create this project. So the amount of time it takes and the amount of the size of the downloads will be dependent on the options you've selected. So you can see I deselected the sub-projects and I've deselected all the extensions just to save a bit of time. So I'm going to pause the video here and wait till this finishes, and then we'll continue by importing this project into Android Studio. Okay, you can't quite see because I haven't got a lot of screen real estate here, but it has actually finished. If I scroll up, you can see build successful. So at this point, we're now done with the libGDX project generator. So I'm going to close that down. Now go back to Android Studio, which I've left open. We go back to the main options, or the main menu. We want to select Import Non-Android Studio Project. Click on that. And we need to navigate to the folder that we've just, where that project has just been created in. And that, of course, was my home folder, Android Studio Projects Test. So I'm just going to click on Test and click OK. This message may or may not come up for you. If it does, click OK because it's OK, and Android Studio via Grader will upgrade automatically. So at this point now, it's going to still do a little bit more analysis of the project and download the relevant files it needs to create an Android Studio project. Now keep in mind here that what it's doing is it's importing the libGDX game framework, you know, the basic skeleton code that we've created into Android Studio, but it's doing it in the same folder. So it's not creating another folder. If you recall, we generated the project in that folder, Android Studio Projects /test. It's creating an infrastructure around that in that same folder. Click on yes to language level changes. And it's just a matter of leaving this to finish and do its thing. Now it may take several minutes, it may take quite a bit of time the first time that you open a project. But once it's done, you can edit it normally as you would any other Android Studio project. So I'm just gonna pause the video now until this is completed. Okay, shouldn't be too much longer now. So again, the first time you do this, it can take quite some time just to update and download and do whatever else it needs to do just to get that project into Android Studio. But that is a once only process. So we'll just wait for this to finish off, and then I'll just quickly go through just to show you some bits and pieces. Not a lot to show, but basically again, this is just the skeleton code for libGDX. From this point forward, you can start creating your code in Android Studio and creating a game and running the game via the emulator or via a physical Android device if you've got one connected. Okay, you can see it's finished now, so do give it plenty of time. It does take a while to finish, but it's a once-only process. So just in terms of some of the folders, you can see the standard Android manifest files there, Java files, resources, and so forth, as you would normally see in a project. The part I want to show you is in core, and you can see this is, again, the package we chose, the class name we chose, and that's the class that gets called or executed on the game start. In this case, it's just set up by default because it's some skeleton code to show the bad logic JPEG on the screen. So that's it. And we're done, dusted, complete, and fully set up. So libGDX is now ready to go on your machine. Please now subscribe to my channel. Click on the subscribe button to the left-hand side and you'll be kept up to date with new videos as I release them. If you've got a moment also, can I ask you to please check out my Android development course. Over 25 hours of video training showing you how to become a better Android developer. Feel free also to peruse some of the videos there to my left-hand side and really get your fill, so to speak, of more Android app goodness. Last but by no means least, please comment on this video, let me know what you thought about it, but also please give me some feedback on what you'd like me to cover in a future video, and I'll aim to do just that, to cover as many of those requests as I can in future videos. This is Tim Buchalka, the Aussie Android Dev Guy, signing off, and I'll see you in a
another video. Cheers for now.